You're watching Poland Daily Business Edition, and we will talk about European issues tonight, because we are just past this big summit of the European Union. 28 nations, leaders of 28 nations gathered and discussed about who will have a top jobs in the European Union. Arthur Włodarski of Lazarski University will be our guide into this bush of various interests. And let us focus on Polish interest first. Poland has been able to influence the decision of those big countries of European Union.
For the first time, by blocking the imposition on Poland and other members of the European Union in Central Europe of a person which would be detrimental to the process of solving problems in the European Union. I mean Frans Timmermans. He was the deputy head of the European Commission until now, and he to some extent made his name on the conflict with Poland, but also with Hungary, by getting involved in internal aspects of our politics, which lay outside of the competences of the European Union, like judiciary, for example, how it should look like, how it should function. It is internal matter of the member state. So we managed successfully to block this person from taking the top position, top job, which would be absolutely negative to Europe, to this climate which we have now, especially now when we have so many problems like Brexit.
Because the Frans Timmermans was instrumental in many discussions that were directed against economical interest of our country.
Of course, we still have a big protective policies in the European Union, and we see that national interests in business count the most. And it's not our fault, our Polish fault. It's fault of Germany and France that we are saying in this way, because they are promoting, first of all, their own businesses and their own national interest. And they are doing this sometimes violating their freedoms, like freedom of services in the European Union, by imposing on us such acts, legal acts, like directive on delegated workers.
Which will affect our transport companies that got about 30 to 40% of the freight, cargo freight
in the European market. Of course, it will limit the freedom of services in the European Union. Or, for example, we have those double standards of food in the European Union. The worst food was going to Central Europe.
Same labels. Higher prices, but
different
ingredients.
Content, different ingredients, of course. And they were saying that actually the tastes are different. That's why it's different, because the Poles are liking something worse. So it was also quite bizarre interpretation why we have double standards of food. But it will be finished now. And also we see Nord Stream 2. It's a good for Germany, maybe, but it's not good for Poland that we have this situation when we have a gas pipeline. But we manage now in the European Union to push through new revised so-called gas directive, which will control to some extent gas pipeline Nord Stream 2.
Right. So we've heard that gas Nord Stream 1 was very beneficial to Germany. The German Chancellor Gerhard Schröder was pursuing this development, and after that he
was
became
awarded
chairman of the company that builds and operates this.
In a strange way, he got a reward at the end of the day.
Right,
so
right.
We see the complication of the situation, but fortunately, due to our growing influence and economic potential, for example, we are becoming the largest trade partner as a bloc. I mean Visegrad Group, for Germany. So I think that Germany is now taking into account what we have to say. And also I think that the election for the top European position of the head of the European Commission, Ursula von der Leyen, is good for Poland. Why? She's Catholic. She was a minister for social issues, social affairs and family. So she is to some extent sensitive to the social policy in Europe. And also she's very pro-American in terms of looking on our security, transatlantic security.
Politics of law and justice in Poland, encouraging people to have families and have lots of kids.
And this confirmed the wisdom of this process, of this policy in family of Ursula von der Leyen. So I think she will be a good ally of the government in Warsaw. Of course, it's completely different person from Franz Timmermans.
Is Poland able to extend its influences over the countries, neighboring countries, in order to achieve its political goals in Europe now?
Actually, Poland created agenda for the whole region, for Central and Southern Europe. Poland is promoting Frisis Initiative, for example, or Bucharest 9. Those initiatives are integrating this part of Europe and are making stronger, are building alliance.
And aside also, of the political alliances, it also has a business side.
And it
promotes the growth and mutual trade.
Here in this region, for example, via Carpathia, for example, a highway from Baltic states to Greece. This is a good example of integrating through infrastructure, new infrastructure, this part of Europe. And also we are inviting other partners, our transatlantic partners, allies, like the United States, for example. So it also, I think, helps to build the reputation for Poland, and it helps to build our strong position in the European Union, because France and Germany must now take into account what we have to say, because we are to some extent becoming also like a competitor to France and Germany. Not anymore we are just a firm approving everything they are saying. We are now creating our own vision for economy development, for politics development. We have something to offer to other states in the region, not only to ourselves.
And that's a new quality of Polish politics. Dr. Artur Rublewski, sir, thank you very much for this
conversation.
And that was it for tonight's Poland Daily Business.